Take exit 1, then keep right at the fork. Keep right at the fork.
Hey everybody, Keith Dotson here, and in this video I have a real treat for you. I was on my way to Moundsville, West Virginia to see an ancient Indian mound, but when I came across the bridge over the Ohio River and my eyes saw the grungy old industrial splendor in the valley below, I knew I had to exit and check it out. And boy am I glad I did. What I discovered was a place like I have never seen before, and I've been around the world. It's an old industrial town that seems frozen in time, but not in a plastic, hermetically sealed way, not in a Disney World fakey kind of way. This is the real deal. South Wheeling, West Virginia. It has retro industrial facilities, it has old churches, quite a few abandoned old buildings, and some that only appeared abandoned but were very much occupied. And it goes on for block after block after block. So much to see that I spent hours walking and driving around here and barely scratched the surface of all the photo ops available. I stayed here so long that I arrived at the mound too late and couldn't even go into the grounds because they'd closed for the day. But I did get to see the mound, and I'll show that to you later in the video. Now, I thought this was abandoned, but it's occupied. I snapped a few quick images from the car window, but the power lines are problematic. Will you look at the go signs on this place? I've seen those old mail pouch tobacco ads on other old buildings in my travels, and believe it or not, this is still a functioning factory. Mail pouch is still an active brand of chewing tobacco. While I was shooting this old church, the owner stepped out to ask what I was doing. He was friendly and said that he was rehabbing it and plans to use the space as an event center. He said it was built around the turn of the century and has had notable parishioners over the years. He gave me his card and invited me to come back to see the inside after it's finished, but honestly, I'm not too interested in seeing it when it's all cleaned up. I would have preferred to see it before the renovation started, to be honest. Sadly, our last stop before we leave South Wheeling, I saw this big red monster looming over the rooftops and had to go investigate. In the background, you can see the highway I came in on. This is the Schmuelbach Brewing Company. It was founded as the Nail City Brewery in 1855 and was overtaken by investors in 1873. Henry Schmuelbach being the majority partner, and he changed the name in 1882. They brought in a master brewer from the famous Gambrinus Brewery in Cincinnati. Wouldn't it be awesome to taste that beer now? Anyways, they were closed down in 1914 when West Virginia passed prohibition laws. As I said before, I got to the mound site too late, but of course I was still able to see it at least. And oh yeah, I forgot about this place. There's an old prison across the street. It's supposed to be quite haunted. I've been to a lot of mound sites, but this is older than most of the ones I've seen before. This one was built between 100 and 250 years BCE. The museum contains artifacts that prove at least 10,000 years of habitation in this region. You could take tours of this old prison too. It was active from 1876 to 1995, if you can believe that. It's been used as a location in a lot of movies and TV shows as well. Well, I hope you enjoy this visit to Wheeling and Moundsville. I fully intend to come back. There's still too much of Wheeling yet to see. Thanks for watching. Be sure to visit my website at keithdotson.com.